It's Tuesday. Tuesday, February 2nd. So we're actually getting into February here. As noted, the shortest month of the year and second shortest day of the month. I realized yesterday while I was editing, I did a live edit, and thanks to everybody who tuned in for that and then lost connection. My internet died as I was complaining about the ills of social media. So that's ironic. Also, sorry about the wind here. But I realized as we were going that I hadn't explained the whole patron producer thing as promised yesterday morning. So today I'm going to actively try and keep that promise and start by saying thanks to Irene Applebaum, today's patron producer. Thank you so much. Good reminder to start off with that, and I'll remember. For the moment, I'm going to keep running. And today's going to be kind of a stay-at-home admin-y day. Not going to be a whole lot going on outside of that. But, you know, I say that and I have no idea. Maybe something will happen in the midst of that. Let's find out. Today got entirely, completely, 100% away from me. It's kind of dark over here. And it's dark because I spent the entire day over there on my computer instead of sitting here in front of the camera talking with you, which I know doesn't make a lot of sense, because why wouldn't I want to sit here and talk to you? You're the best part of my day. Just got to brighten the place up a little bit because it ain't bright enough in here. So today's more or less turning into, this video today is turning more or less into a little bit of an update video to kind of fill you in on some things that I've left hanging or things that I've just been asked a lot about recently. And I hope you're okay with that, because that's all you got. It's already like almost 9 o'clock, and I'm going to have a phone call with my lovely sister here in a minute. And that's going to be great. But I've literally just been sitting over there working all day. I can't yet tell you exactly what I'm working on in some areas, but some I can. For one, yesterday I said I was going to talk about the patron producer situation, what that is, what that means, and how I'm going about it. Not differently, but I'm just actually getting back to reality, and I'm, you know, going to make some excuses for why I kind of fell off the horse there. Not excuses, sort of excuses, reasons. I'm going to give you some reasons. And those reasons mostly are pandemic reasons. I mean, really, we're all pretty exhausted and tired, and everything's been a little bit scattered, and without a regular schedule, which is something that I've been struggling to figure out, it's pretty hard to stay on top of the organization or everything. But patron producers, like today's second patron producer, because why not throw two in here while the throne is good, Jennifer Smith, who's making me a hat, which might, Jennifer, I'm really looking forward to the hat. It's really warm here, so hopefully it gets cold again so I can fully enjoy the hat before. Apparently we're already headed into spring. It's been like in the 50s this week, which is pretty crazy. Like around 13, 14 degrees Celsius. Bananas. But you see what I just did there? I thanked someone very directly for being a patron of mine, but not just thanking them. I want to give them credit for making this possible. Because the thing is, when I say a patron producer, it's one way of highlighting an individual. My hetero life partner, Jeff, always talks about how much better my videos have gotten since I went full time. And that's thanks entirely to my patrons. I mean, really, I'm not even gonna say almost entirely. It's thanks to my patrons. I was trying to think of different ways that I could thank my patrons. I do this in a number of ways. One is that I send loyalty stickers to everybody after 6 months and after a year. So I just send those out as thank yous, ways of saying thank you for being here, thank you for sticking around. After 2 years, we were sending out a variety of different things. That whole system is actually kind of up in the air right now too, partially pandemic, but mostly because Kate is moving on to greener pastures. You can shed a tear for Kate, that's totally fine, I do. And then also, hold on. Also, I have opportunities to do so just by sending out random postcards, often with some extra fun stuff lying around that I just send to my patrons randomly. They don't know they're getting it. They just pop up. I just like to send that kind of stuff. I also like to give, you know, freebies and early releases and things like that. I've been a little bit off my like organizational rhythm for, you know, 2020. Everything's just kind of falling apart to some degree. But I'm doing okay. For the most part, I'm doing okay. I'll give myself an 8 out of 10. I'm getting a B. A B minus. But I want to get back up to an A. And part of that is the organization of actually randomizing my patrons to give them credit to be producers, to come back full circle around to that, what I was trying to say earlier, which is that if it wasn't for you, my patrons, if you're watching this right now and you're one of my patrons, or you've ever been a patron, you don't have to be an active patron right now. Maybe you were a patron in the past for a while and you stopped for one reason or another, but thank you for being a patron at all, ever, because without you, my YouTube channel would not have grown and improved nearly as much as it has. Patreon, if you're not aware yet, because I'm sure most of you probably are, but Patreon is a membership service where between the creator, like me, and the viewer, like you, a little bit of an agreement is made, whether anything from basically being treated like a tip jar, where you go and you support the creators that you love because you just love what they make and you want them to keep making it, or because they give you extra perks and bonuses. I try to give perks and bonuses. I try to be generous, and in the past I've been definitely too generous at times with some of the things that I've sent. Was that a humble brag? I didn't mean to humble brag with that. I'm trying to be like, I need to be smarter about this than I have been at various points in my short career. But it's a great way to directly support the content creators, whether they're podcasters, musicians, comic artists, or YouTubers like me. I mean, it's phenomenal. Otherwise, we're relying on things like ad revenue, which is very, very, well, it's not great to begin with. You can't make a living off of that. At least I can't at my level. And it's also not, it fluctuates a lot. And other methods, you know, I really like the relationship. I like the element of Patreon. I'm really, really grateful for my patrons. So much so that I actually read out the name of every single patron at the back of my book. I wrote them at the back of my book. But every single patron I'd ever had, I also read them out loud in the audiobook, which is one of the updates that I'm going to get to here in a second. But all that to say, the way that I'm handling the patron producer thing is literally I download a spreadsheet of all my active patrons at the beginning of the month. I randomize it somehow, like I'll sort it by a different category each month. And then I go to a random number generator, usually just Google's random number generator, put the number 1 to however many patrons there are, hit generate, find them in the list, write down their name, and then do that whole thing over again until I've got, you know, 20 to 25 names. In the past, I would actually assign that to a day, and so on my calendar I had your name on that day, and that way I would remember to thank you on that day. And if for whatever reason I forgot, or it just didn't fit in, or whatever, I would just grab you and move you to the next day, you know, and keep it going like that. To make it easier this time, I've actually dropped it into a to-do list. So it's just a checklist of all the names, and that way I can check them off as I go each day. So I'm gonna check off a couple names today. And that way I keep track of it, and again, if for whatever reason, like I'm probably gonna go on a little bit of a break from making vlogs for at least a few days, because I haven't gone on a break for a while, and I need to, because I have so much work to do. You know, or I just, you know, forget, or whatever happens, that way it's all right there, and I can get right back to it. That's basically the patron producer thing, and again, it's just a way of, if you like having your name shouted out, great, it's gonna be whatever you put in there for your display name, not your shipping name, don't worry. So if you don't want your legal name going in there, I can always use whatever your display name is. That's what I default to, at least. Just so you know going into it, in case you wanna include like a spouse or anybody else in the title. Some people have gone back and edited their names to include whoever it is that they're partnering up with to support me. So just make sure you do that, because I'm just going off whatever that name is, because I'm assuming, you know, like Palm Trees in Paris, for example, just to throw out a name. I'm not gonna say her real name, because she uses Palm Trees in Paris everywhere, and I'm just gonna assume for safety and everything else that she doesn't want her name being read out on the internet. Have I gone down this path too far? I think I've gone down this path too far. Now I gotta raise the seat again. You get the idea, patron producers, that all makes a lot of sense. Also the light's behind me now. Other updates. Hopefully that all made sense. We'll condense the update section now that we're here. Audiobook, since I just mentioned it. Finally got the remastered files uploaded. They rejected the first round because there were a couple of errors in some of the files. So Tamal went back in and cleaned those up. I've re-uploaded those, like as of today, I think was when I finally got them back up. Should have gotten them up a week ago. Hopefully the audiobook will be ready. It is available to patrons at the $10 level and up already. You'll get that link in your welcome email. So if you want the audiobook now, it's already available for patrons. Plug, 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 plug. The bike, the Van Moof, is phenomenal. I've been asked a lot about the Van Moof situation. I'm loving it. Thank you to everybody who pitched in to make that possible. Thanks to everybody for putting up with, along with me, the long ride to actually get it. The fourth one was the charm, seems to be at least right now. One minor concern is that sometimes it hasn't charged fully to 100% on the battery, but then most of the time it seems to be doing that. So I'm gonna mention that to them. But otherwise, it is a dream to ride. It's so fast. I get around town so quickly, and I just lose time. Somebody was joking about that on Twitter, that like, I didn't realize that we were out of January. Like, the second half of January is a total blur to me. And they pointed out that I've been riding my bike that whole time, and I think that might be it. It's just such a pleasure to go ride around that I've completely forgotten what the rest of existence is all about. Speaking of modes of transportation, the wheel is still in temporary retirement. Partially because I realized, and I said this in a video not too long ago, but part of the reason that I'm less inclined to ride it, one is that it's just kind of bad for your, like, everything, really, to ride, and two, I mean, it's fun, but it's not good for your joints especially, and then two, I've had enough problems with it recently that, like, when I was riding it last, when it was slipping and just errors, that I don't fully trust it to be safe anymore. It's not a great thing. It's not a great feeling to have for a mode of transportation that you're trusting, you know, your life to. I don't think I'm going to get really seriously injured on it. It's a very safe thing. Like, you can literally just run off of it if it crashes. But it's more, some of those unbalancing maneuvers that it was pulling would be pretty bad, like throwing you off the thing backwards kind of a thing. So I want to get back to it. I want to see how it goes from there, and we'll handle it. Yeah, I need to take it out for some test rides and see how I feel about it, actually. I need to build my confidence back up in it. That said, the guys that repair it for me were like, wow, you've got a lot of mileage out of this. These little guys don't often last this long. I put well over 1,000 kilometers onto it. And so I don't want to retire it because I really do like it. We're going to have to figure that one out, though. Kate, as I mentioned, has started her new internship at Poilin, which is exciting, and I'm looking forward to hearing more about it as well. It means that she's reduced, obviously she's not working for me in most capacities, so you won't be interacting with her in most arenas of where you might have in the past. However, she is still gonna do the newsletter twice a month, and she's assembling the newsletter for me still, and then writing it twice a month. So I'm gonna be writing again in the newsletter more than I was before, which is really good. I wrote for it today, and I miss it. So I'm looking forward to doing that. If you haven't subscribed to the newsletter yet, be sure to do that below. Talk a lot about just what's going on in Paris, what's going on with the vlogs. This is a very catch-all kind of thing, and Kate has her own corner in it that hopefully we'll maintain for a while, because it's really nice, where she talks about drinks she's been making at home during quarantine, or shopping tips if you're in Paris, or just some of the things that she's learning in her brand and fashion and brand management course. One of those combinations. So it's really fun. It's really great. And if you want to see the photos of the day, uncropped, un-Instagrammed, that's another spot that you can do it right then and there, which is pretty cool. I think I'm kind of caught up. Can't talk about secret projects yet. We're getting closer. One of them in particular. We're doing some family friend testing here, finding some interesting stuff out as we go, learning, making changes. So that's good. My parents are doing well. My mom is doing well. My dad is skiing a lot, which is great. He's ahead of me on the leaderboard right now for the running. I did make it to 80 miles running in January, which I'm really proud of. And it's gonna be hard to make 80 miles in February because it's a shorter month, but I'm feeling overall really good about the running. I'm gonna talk more about the habits that I've been working on and developing. I'm just feeling overall very good. I'd say only one or two days out of the week generally are very down, and the rest of them are okay to great, which I'm very grateful for. I just feel like I'm coming out of burnout for the first time in a year and a half. And this is one of the things I was gonna talk about. One of the reasons that I'm slow to get caught up on some things like Patreon, vlogging, other stuff is that I do have a lot of things I need to get done, like visa, that's another thing. Man, I'm coming up with all kinds of update stuff now here at the end. The visa process, I'm working on the paperwork. My meeting is not far from now, so I've got to get that together, but I'm feeling pretty good about that. You know, for those of you that are going to ask immediately to follow up, the citizenship stuff can't happen until that's over, so like I can't ask for French citizenship until I've stayed here longer, and that requires updating or renewing my visa, so I need to do that. The bank situation is still a nightmare, all of that. But that stuff notwithstanding, and things that I absolutely have to get done so I can just stay in the country, I've been kind of slowing my roll on a number of fronts and not jumping into things like making a stream schedule or, you know, committing to making all kinds of other videos, things that I really want to do that I've been talking about that I do want to do until I want to take some time to really think through and establish some habits, but also how I'm approaching 2021 so that I'm setting myself up for the best chance of success. Because at the end of the day, that success is going to depend pretty heavily on me not burning out again. And not just surviving, but like finding a way to thrive in the midst of the pandemic, whatever comes after the pandemic, however life kind of resumes afterwards, and whatever struggles come afterwards. I want to make sure that I've set myself up to be the healthiest version of myself possible. And with this resurgence of energy that I've been having and really feeling, I mean, many of you have commented on it because you're seeing it, that resurgence of energy traditionally is one that I take and just run with and sprint straight towards burning out again as fast as I possibly can. And I'm already doing too much as it is. And so I'm trying to take some steps back, calm myself down, and figure out, okay, like, what do I do from here? Where do I go from here? And how do I approach this year the happiest and the healthiest way possible? And I'm sure you can understand that. But it also means that, you know, I'm going to be stumbling into 2021 a little bit, is what it's going to look and feel like. But on the back end, I'm actually taking my time to really think things through, reflect, and dive deeper into therapy, dive deeper into the time that I spend with all of this so that I can make hopefully the best decisions possible. And that's a pretty good update video, I feel like. There's probably more to talk about. I'm sure that I missed something. Feel free to let me know in the comments below. Maybe we'll do a Q&A one of these days soon. Obviously, live streaming is a good opportunity for that. I'll be streaming on Twitch more in the future. I just am not committing to when yet because I want to make sure that, again, I'm not going to burn myself out and that everything I'm doing actually makes some sort of sense for what I'm building and working towards in the future. Because if I'm going to have a career out of all this stuff and build out and up, I need to make sure that I'm investing wisely with my time and energy, because I've definitely invested brashly with both before. I have some tendencies that way. Anyway, I hope you're doing well wherever it is you are. I hope that you're having some resurgence of energy. I will be sharing more about, like, we're going to do the coffee station here soon. I'll be talking about the habits and what I've been thinking about and how I've been trying to reorganize myself and put everything in line. But I also want to actually put these things into practice before I talk about them, instead of just talking about the exciting possibilities. It's all coming and it'll be here soon. So if you haven't, also one of the things I need to work on, I'm not going to ask people to subscribe much, if at all, because I already don't do that as much as I probably should. But one of the things that I've been learning on the YouTube side of things is it's more important to ask people to like your video, because it's something that the algorithm really likes. So if you'd like to help me out with the algorithm, that'd be great if you would hit that like button under the video, because it does help. And then if you'd like to consider supporting me, working with me, being a Patreon producer, making these videos possible and making them better, the more of you there are, the better they get. And I'm just the more love I feel in general. But if you want to become a patron, head over to patreon.com/jswanson and you can support me that way too. And I'd greatly appreciate it. And I hope you're doing well. And I will see you bright and early. Probably not tomorrow morning, but I'm going to be making another couple of videos this week. So I'll see you bright and early a couple more times this week. And we'll figure it out as we go. Don't you worry. I'm figuring it out. You're figuring it out too. All right. I'll see you in a couple days.